Namaskar, hello and welcome to NCERT's live phone-in program. My name is Tanvi Khurana and this is a maths class where we are going to learn about real numbers. What are real numbers and how do you identify that these are the real numbers? Well, we have an expert who will be talking about real numbers and she'll be solving a few questions as well. If you have any questions, please share it to us. And all the class 10th students, this session is for you. Real numbers part 1. You can send your questions, queries on our email ID dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. You're watching us on PM eVidya channel number 10. All right. Without wasting any more time, let's just meet the expert we have with us, Ms. Savita Graak. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Tanvi, and a very good afternoon to all of our peers.
Good afternoon to you too, ma'am. Ma'am is a teacher from Gita Niketan Avasiya Vidyalaya Kurukshetra. And let's just ask her, ma'am, what is it that you're going to teach our students in this particular class? And to begin with, what are real numbers?
Right, Tanvi, first of all, we all know that it is the very first session for the students of class 10th. The students who were viewing our sessions regularly, they were in class 9th and now they have been admitted to class 10th, and this is the very first session as far as mathematics is concerned to these students. And the topic which we are starting with, it is real numbers. So what do we mean by real numbers? All the numbers which are real are known as real number, means they are existing in reality. There are some numbers which are not real, these are known as imaginary numbers, but today we will discuss about real numbers only. So here we have defined real numbers, all the numbers that can be found or that can be presented on a number line are known as real numbers. Real numbers can be positive, they can be negative, they can be in decimal form or they can be in fractional form. So here we have given some of the examples of real numbers. These are 5, minus 7, in the form of a fraction 1 upon 2, in the form of decimal it's 0.312. Similarly, root 2, it is an irrational number. Dear students, you already have studied about rational numbers and irrational numbers, but today we are once revising all of these numbers again, and then we will come to the topic which is directly related to your class 10. So for the first, here we have drawn a number line. Of course, such type of number line we have also drawn in our earlier classes. From class 6th, we have started drawing a number line. First of all, we were presenting natural numbers on a number line, and after that we have started presenting integers on a number line, and after that we have started presenting fractions on a number line. So let us know about natural numbers first of all. What do we mean by natural numbers? All counting numbers are known as natural numbers. Counting number means the numbers which are countable. For example, if I am writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 100, then 1,000, then 1 lakh, 1 crore, these all numbers are known as natural numbers. And the very first natural number is 1, or we can say that which one is the smallest natural number. So 1 is the smallest natural number. Now, the natural numbers are denoted by capital N. If I am saying there is a number N which belongs to N, that means this N must be a natural number. So every natural number can be denoted by capital N. After discussing about natural numbers, let us discuss about the whole numbers. What do we mean by whole numbers? Actually, natural number means the numbers which are existing already in the nature. If we are standing on a road and we see some bikes passing by. So if these are total 3 motorbikes, so we will say 1, 2 and 3. if there is one tree in front of my house, I will say it is one. So all the things which are existing naturally are known as natural numbers. So which number is there which is representing the non-existence of something? If I am saying there is not even a single tree in front of my house, if I am saying there is not even a single teacher in the school on a holiday, so which number is that which is telling us about the non-existence of something? It is nothing else than a zero. So if we are adding a zero to the natural numbers, then this new set becomes the set of whole numbers. And the set of whole numbers is presented by W. It is W. So simply, if I am saying that this is the set of natural numbers, and if I am adding a zero to it, then this complete set becomes the set of whole numbers. So here we have also talked about that every natural number is always a whole number, but every whole number is not natural. It is not natural. The reason being behind it, that zero is a whole number but is not natural. Now let us discuss about integers. What do you mean by integers? Now we just have studied about the natural numbers, then we have added a zero to the group of natural numbers, and now we are adding the negative of all the natural numbers to this group. Means if one is a natural number, then its negative will be minus 1. If 3 is a natural number, then its negative is minus 3. So if we will add the negatives of all the natural numbers to the set of whole numbers, thus the numbers becomes integers. So the new set with us is the set of integers, and this is the set, all the negative numbers, then minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, then a 0, then 1, 2, 3, and all the positive numbers. So all the whole numbers are integers, but all the integers are not whole numbers. Now the next which we are going to discuss about which our students have studied in their class 9th as well, this is rational numbers. Which type of numbers are known as rational numbers? Actually all the numbers which can be presented in the form of P upon Q, or we can say A upon B, where the denominator is not equal to 0 and both the numerator and denominator are integers. Integers means these can be positive, these can be negative. So all the numbers which can be written in the form P by Q, where Q is not equals to 0, are called rational numbers, and it is a must that P and Q both are integers. So here I have given an example that 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is a rational number. Why it is? Because in 2 by 3, if we are talking about 2 by 3, here 2 is an integer, 3 is also an integer, and the fraction 2 by 3, in this fraction, 3 is not equals to 0. That is why this is a rational number. Similarly, this question can be asked many times, that 0 is a rational number or not? So what 0 is? If you are talking about 0, so simply 0 can be written as 0 by 1, as we have also written it here. That means 0 and 1 both are integers and the denominator is not 0. Therefore 0 will always be known as a rational number. So we are talking about that there can be infinitely many rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. अगर हमारे पास दो rational numbers exist करते हैं, तो उन दोनों rational numbers के बीच में infinitely many rational numbers exist कर सकते हैं. If I am saying there is a rational number 2 by 3, there is another rational number 4 by 3, तो इन दोनों rational numbers के बीच में भी infinitely many rational numbers होंगे. यहाँ पर हमने discuss किया है complete real number system को. अगर हम रियल नंबर्स का डिवीजन करते हैं, तो रियल नंबर्स को बेसिकली हम टू पार्ट्स में डिवाइड कर सकते हैं. कौन कौन से पार्ट्स? द फर्स्ट पार्ट इज रेशनल नंबर्स एंड द सेकंड पार्ट इज irrational numbers. Dear viewers, let us also talk about ki rational numbers ko hum show karte hain by Q. So the complete chart has been shown here, and let us start from natural numbers and then in an upward direction. Natural numbers, of course, all the numbers starting from 1, then whole numbers, 0 will be added to the group of natural numbers, then integers, all the negatives will be added to this group, to the group of whole numbers, and then rational numbers, all the numbers which are presented in the form of a by b, where b is not equals to 0, but a and b both are integers. And what about the irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are, of course, those numbers which are not rational. That means irrational number can never be written in the form of p by q if p and q are integers. So, in which form can we write the irrational numbers? These can be written as root 2. This is an irrational number. Root 3 is an irrational number. And pi is also an irrational number. Let us talk about pi here. We know that most of the time we write pi as 22 by 7. तो अभी हमारे mind में question आ रहा होगा कि अगर pi को हम 22 by 7 लिखते हैं, that means अगर हम pi को p by q form में लिखते हैं, so it must be rational. But let us know about that 22 upon 7 is not an accurate value of pi, but it is an approximate value of pi. Hamare questions ko hum easily solve kar paye. Pi ki jo actual value hai, that never ends. This is an irrational number. That's why hum use karte hain ek approximate value 22 upon 7 in place of pi. Abhi real number ke hi chart ko ek bar hum fir se dekh lein ki natural numbers ka set. नेचुरल नंबर सेट में अगर जीरो ऐड कर दें तो यहां तक कंप्लीट बन जाता है होल नंबर्स का सेट. होल नंबर्स के सेट में अगर हम कुछ नेगेटिव नंबर्स ऐड कर देते हैं तो दिस कंप्लीट बिकम्स द सेट ऑफ इंटीजर्स. एंड देन अगर फ्रैक्शनल नंबर भी इंटीजर्स में ऐड कर दिए जाए सो दिस बिकम्स द सेट ऑफ रेशनल्स. और इरेशनल नंबर इज वेरी मच डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ दीज. कोई भी नेचुरल नंबर, कोई भी होल नंबर, कोई भी रेशनल और कोई भी इंटीजर कभी भी इरेशनल नहीं हो सकता. लेकिन रेशनल और इरेशनल का जब कॉम्बिनेशन हम करते हैं सो दैट बिकम्स रियल नंबर्स. अभी कुछ एक और नंबर्स को हम डिफाइन करेंगे एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस टुडे अबाउट यूक्लिड्स डिविजन लेमा. सो हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इवन नंबर्स. व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय इवन नंबर्स? Of course, our viewers know about even numbers. All the numbers which are divisible by 2. These are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and many more. These all numbers are known as even numbers. And what do we mean by odd numbers? Odd numbers are those which cannot be divided by 2 or which are not completely divisible by 2. These are 1, 3, 5, 7 and many. तो हम यहाँ पर natural numbers को categorize कर रहे हैं in the form of even numbers, then in the form of odd numbers. And now let us talk about the prime numbers. Which type of numbers are known as prime numbers? Prime numbers are those which have only two factors. The factors will not be less than 2 and even will not be more than 2. There will be only two factors. And which will be these two factors? One of the factor will be 1 and the other will be the number itself. For example, if I am talking about a number 5 aur hum baat karein ki 5 kis kis table se divisible hai, so these are only two numbers, whether 1 and the other is 5. 5 1 ke table par aur 5 ke table par completely aata hai, that means the remainder becomes 0 in these two cases only. Therefore, 5 will be known as a prime number. So, the next is composite numbers. Which type of numbers are known as composite? The numbers which have more than 2 factors. Aise sabhi numbers jinke 2 se zyada factors hote hain. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द नंबर फोर, तो फोर के कितने फैक्टर्स होते हैं? द नंबर फोर हैज एग्जैक्टली थ्री फैक्टर्स, वन टू एंड फोर. तो क्योंकि फोर के फैक्टर्स दो से ज्यादा है इसलिए हम बोलेंगे फोर इज अ कंपोजिट नंबर. तो हमने एक बार रिकॉल कर लिया कि प्राइम नंबर्स आर दो जिनके दो फैक्टर्स होते हैं एंड कंपोजिट नंबर्स आर दो जिनके दो से ज्यादा फैक्टर्स होते हैं. अब डिस्कस करते हैं क्या कोई ऐसा नंबर है विच इज नाइदर ओड नॉर इवन. तो ऐसा कौन सा नंबर है जो ना ओड होता है और ना ही इवन होता है? दैट नंबर इज ऑफ कोर्स वन, क्योंकि वन एक ऐसा नंबर है जिसका सिर्फ एक ही फैक्टर है एंड दैट फैक्टर इज वन इटसेल्फ. और इसी तरह से एक और अगर हम इंटरेस्टिंग यहां पर टॉपिक बात डिस्कस करते हैं, दैट इज विच टाइप ऑफ नंबर इज टू. टू इज द ओनली इवन प्राइम नंबर. हमारे पास ऐसे बहुत सारे नंबर्स हैं जो इवन होते हैं, एंडलेस, 2, 4, 400, 8 lakh, ऑल द नंबर्स विच आर डिविजिबल बाय 2. हमारे पास ऐसे भी बहुत सारे नंबर्स हैं विच आर प्राइम, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13 एंड मेनी मोर. बट 2 इज द ओनली नंबर विच इज इवन एज वेल एज प्राइम. And after this, we are discussing about the co-prime numbers. What do we mean by co-prime numbers? Co-prime numbers are those. सबसे पहली बात हम बात करें, co-words is telling us that here we will discuss about more than one number. For example, अगर मैं सिर्फ एक ही नंबर लिख दूँ 7, और आपसे पूछते हैं कि 7 is 7 odd, तो you will say yes. Is 7 prime? So our answer is yes. Is 7 even? So our answer is no. But we are talking about is 7 co-prime. So this is an invalid question. When the word co is there, that means there will be minimum two numbers. For example, I am writing one number is 7 and other number is 15. So कोई भी ऐसे दो numbers जिन दोनों numbers का HCF 1 होता है, these are known as co-prime numbers. Or we can say two numbers whose highest common factor is 1 are known as co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers को लेकर हम यहाँ पर एक बहुत ही important discussion अपनी class 10th में करने वाले हैं. So before that, let us discuss about Euclid's division lemma. Now what do we mean by Euclid's division lemma? First of all, this is something which about which we are already aware because of our lower classes. For example, I would like to explain this definition with the help of an example. I am taking a number 15 and we are dividing this number by 7. So if we have to divide 15 by 7, so what it will be? The quotient will be 2 and the remainder is 1 here. So we know that the dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Divisor into quotient plus remainder. Here R is representing a remainder. So we have done this concept in our lower classes. That means in class 4th, in class 5th, in class 6th we have done it. But now we are doing the same thing, but we are writing it in a different form, in a different way. Since this concept has been given by the mathematician Euclid, that's why this is known as Euclid's division lemma. And what this lemma is, now I'm rewriting this division procedure again. I'm writing it as, if a number A is divided by B, hum same division ki generalization kar rahe hain, aur general numbers yahan par lete hain, number A and B, both are positive integers. These integers are integer A and integer B. Let us take it as small. And on division, we are getting Q as quotient and R as remainder. So we can write down that A is equal to BQ plus R. Because here dividend is A, divisor is B, quotient is Q, and our remainder is small r. So same चीज हमने लिखी है और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट जो चीज है देखने वाली वो है कि रिमाइंडर विल ऑलवेज बी ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू जीरो बट लेस देन बी. जो रिमाइंडर की वैल्यू है वो कभी भी नेगेटिव हम नहीं लेते. जैसे अभी हमने ये डिविजन की तो रिमाइंडर इज वन हियर. ऐसे में एक और डिवीजन करके दिखाती हूँ. लेट मी से कि हम 15 को डिवाइड कर रहे हैं बाय 4. तो हम कभी भी ऐसा नहीं लिखते कि 4 4s are 16 एंड रिमाइंडर इज माइनस 1. हम जब नेचुरल नंबर्स को डिवाइड कर रहे हैं डायरेक्टली डिवाइड कर रहे हैं सो वी विल राइट इट एज 4 times 3 is 12. And of course, our remainder is what? It is positive 3. बिल्कुल ऐसे ही अगर एक और हम बात करें कि 4 से जब आप 15 को डिवाइड कर रहे हो तो क्लास में कितने भी स्टूडेंट्स को टीचर ये क्वेश्चन दे दे हर बच्चे के लिए जो आंसर है वो यूनिक रहेगा. ऐसा नहीं है कोई बच्चा बोलेगा मैम द क्वेश्चन इज 2, कोई दूसरा स्टूडेंट बोलेगा द क्वेश्चन इज 3 एंड द टीचर विल से या यू बोथ आर राइट यू बोथ आर करेक्ट. नो, these integers are unique. This is an important concept to know. And 4 times 3 is 12. If any child is writing that 4 times 2 is 8 and the remainder is 7, so is he correct or not? So 100% the child is not correct. Why he is not correct? Kyunki yahan par jo remainder hai वो 4 से ज्यादा आ रहा है विच इज नेवर नेवर पॉसिबल. सो द ओनली यूनिक वे एंड करेक्ट वे फॉर दिस डिवीजन इज प्रेजेंटेड हियर. दैट्स व्हाई वी विल से a इक्वल्स टू bq प्लस r. सो दिस लेमा इज नोन एज यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा. एंड नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट लेमा एंड देन एल्गोरिथम. What is the difference between, we are going to solve a few questions which we will solve by using Euclid's division algorithm. तो उससे पहले हम एक बार देख लेते हैं कि लेमा और algorithm में difference क्या है. Lemma is a proven statement which is used to prove many other statements. But what algorithm is? Algorithm is a series of well-defined steps. यानी जब हम अपनी lemma को use करेंगे in various steps so that becomes a series और हम उस procedure को तब क्या बोलेंगे that becomes an algorithm. And here we are defining Euclid's division algorithm. Euclid, which I have already discussed that he was a Greek mathematician and he derived an interesting method for finding HCF. So now we will learn that how can we find HCF by using Euclid's division algorithm of two or more numbers. And in order to find the HCF of two positive integers, integer A and integer B, we have to work upon the following steps. The very first step is, we will first of all identify the given two numbers. Then we will take the greater number as dividend and the smaller number as divisor, and then we will go for reason. Thus, we will be able to find some quotient and we will also be able to find some remainder. जब हमने dividend को divide किया with our divisor, so कुछ ना कुछ quotient और कुछ ना कुछ remainder आएगा. But the important thing is this over here, that if the remainder is zero, then the divisor will be the required HCF. अगर first step पर ही मान लीजिए मैं बोलती हूँ कि find the HCF of two numbers 2 and 6 और हमने greater number 6 को divide किया smaller number 2 से. So we can easily say that 2 times 3 is 6 and in that case remainder is 0. So what we will say? We will say कि very first step पर remainder is becoming 0. So 2 is our HCF. But what if remainder is not equals to 0? Here we have written otherwise. Otherwise means when remainder is not equals to 0, in that case the remainder will become the new divisor and the previous divisor it will become the new dividend, and the process will be continued up to when the remainder will not become 0. तो अभी हमने जो स्टेप्स डिस्कस किए इन्हें हम विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन एक बार सॉल्व कर लेते हैं ताकि कॉन्सेप्ट बिकम्स मोर क्लियर टू अस. The question is, use Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of two numbers, and these two numbers are 135 and 225. So let us start. सबसे पहले हमने दोनों numbers को recognize करना है. Then we will see कि greater number is 225 and this 225 will be divided by 135. The question is 1 at the first step and we are able to get the remainder to be 90. Now what about 90? 90 is equal to 0 or not? Of course 90 is not equal to 0. So 90 will become the divisor in the next step and 135, that means the previous divisor, it will become the dividend now. And this process will be continued up to when we will not be able to get a zero over there as remainder. Now 90 times 1 is of course 90 and 45 is the remainder. And after this step, the next step will be 45. The remainder becomes the divisor and 90 becomes the dividend. This time we are able to get the remainder to be 0. And if the remainder is 0, the divisor of the same step is known as the HCF. Ab baat karte hain ki how can we write it by using our Euclid division algorithm. So it can be written as 225 is equal to divisor. What was the divisor for the first step? It is 135 into quotient plus remainder. So we have to write it in the form A equals to BQ plus R, which we just have learned through Euclid division lemma. And this process will be continued up to last. Now at the next step will be 135. It is equals to 90 times 1 plus 45. And the next step will be 90 is equal to the divisor 45 into quotient 2 plus remainder 0. So at this step we are able to get that the remainder is 0. And if the remainder is 0, that's why we will say that our HCF is 45. I hope it is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
तो अभी इसी तरह के कुछ और क्वेश्चंस हम डिस्कस करेंगे और फिर यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा ही और किस तरह के क्वेश्चंस को सॉल्व करने में हमारे काम आ सकता है, कुछ और तरह के कॉन्सेप्ट्स भी हम आज ही डिस्कस करेंगे. द नेक्स्ट इज वी हैव टू फाइंड द एचसीएफ ऑफ टू नंबर्स एंड दीज टू नंबर्स आर 210 एंड 55 एंड हियर इट इज गिवन दैट द एचसीएफ इज एक्सप्रेसिबल इन द फॉर्म 210 इनटू 5 प्लस 55 वाई. We have to find the value of y. So simply it has been given to us that HCF को हम इस form में लिख सकते हैं. तो question में इस बार directly नहीं बोला गया कि आप HCF calculate करें. But we have to calculate the HCF and we will put that HCF equals to this expression. So let us see. 55, 210. What can we say 55 times 3? What it is? It is of course 165. And what the remainder is there? It is 45. Then the question will be done similarly as we have done the previous one. Now we will have to divide 45 by 10. And now we have 5 as remainder and at this step we are able to get that our remainder is 0. That is why we will say that our HCF becomes 5. HCF is 5. Now the HCF is 5 and we are now talking about how to calculate the value of y. We know that the HCF is equal to, which was given to us, 210 times 5 plus 55 into y. So what we will do, we will put the value 5, the HCF equal to the given expression. That means 210 into 5, or we can also solve it at the same step. What it will be, it is 1050. 1050 plus 55y equals to 5. Thus we can see that 55y, and our viewers can easily solve this, and at this step we will be able to find the value of y. Okay, so first we have solved a few questions, two questions in which we have learned how can we find HCF by using Euclid's division lemma. And now what we are doing, we are discussing about some statement based questions or some questions based on the real life, that how can we solve such type of questions, or how do we come to know that we have to calculate the HCF or LCM for solving a particular question. Here the question is, three sets of English, then Hindi and mathematics books. These have to be stacked. These have to be stacked properly in an order, English books and then mathematics books and then Hindi books. Let me say these are representing our Hindi books, these are representing our English books, and then mathematics books are there. Okay, these have to be stacked in such a way that the books stored topic wise, and the important thing is that the height of each stack is same. The height for each stack is same. The number of English books are given to us to be 96. The number of Hindi books 240. And the number of mathematics books is given here 36. Assuming that the books are of same thickness, it has also been given that the thickness of each and every book, the thickness of each and every book is same. हमें calculate क्या करना है? We have to determine the number of stacks of English books and then Hindi books and then mathematics books. So what we have to calculate in this question, we will have to calculate HCF for all of these numbers which are we are able to get, that means 96 and then 240 and then 336. In this way we will be able to get that how many books will be there in one stack. Aur agar hame pata chal jayega ki ek stack mein kitni book aane wali hai, to hame number of stacks batane mein bhi bahut easy rahe. So first of all we will find the HCF of all these three numbers. अभी हम जान चुके हैं कि दो नंबर्स का HCF कैसे निकालते हैं. Let us take two smaller numbers here. That means 96 and 240. And if you are taking 96 and 240, then you can say that 96 times 2, it is 192. And then 48 is the remainder. And then 96. It must be 48 times 2 is 96 itself. So we have remainder 0 at this step. So we samajh aa raha hai ki 48 jo hai, that is the HCF of two numbers, and these two numbers are 96 and 240. Lekin yahan par hamare paas two numbers ka HCF nikalna will not be sufficient, kyunki mathematics books are also there and the number for these books are 336. तो अभी हम क्या करेंगे, क्या मेथड रहता है थ्री नंबर्स का HCF अगर हमें निकालना है. पहले हम टू नंबर्स का HCF निकाल दें, और जो HCF वहां से आया है वी विल स्टार्ट डूइंग द सेम प्रोसीजर विद द थर्ड नंबर, दैट मींस 336. नाउ लेट अस सी कि अगर हम 48 से 336 को डिवाइड करते हैं तो इन दैट केस व्हाट विल बी द क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर. We can see that if I am dividing 8 and we are taking 8 as quotient, so 8 times 8 is 64, and in that case 8 times 4 is 32, and 32 plus 6 it is 38, which is of course greater than this 336. So hame kya karna hoga, we will take the quotient to be 7, and now we can see that 7 times 8 is 56, and then we are able to get the remainder to be 0 at the very first step. So we are able to find that the FCF is 48. FCF of for all of these three numbers is 48. That means हमें समझ आ रहा है कि वन स्टैक में हम वन कितनी बुक्स लगाएंगे, 48 बुक्स लगाएंगे. तो हमें समझ आ गया कि FCF आ रहा है 48. We know that the total number of Hindi books and then the total number of mathematics books and English language books, these are given to be for English language 96, for Hindi language 240, 96, 240, and for mathematics there are total 336 books. तो क्वेश्चन में अगर सिर्फ ये पूछा जाता कि वन स्टैक में कितनी बुक्स अरेंज की जाएंगी, तो ऑफ कोर्स ये 48 ही हमारा फाइनल आंसर होता. बट वी हैव नॉट बीन आस्क्ड दिस, हमें पूछा गया है टोटल नंबर ऑफ स्टैक्स. तो हमें समझ जाना चाहिए कि 48 बुक्स का एक एक ग्रुपिंग होना है, तो 96 बुक्स के कितने ग्रुप्स रहेंगे, दीज विल बी टू, देयर विल बी टू स्टैक्स. देन 240 बुक्स के लिए number of stacks will be what, 240 divided by 48, which will of course be 5. And then for mathematics books there will be total 7 stacks, kyunki agar hum 48 se 336 ko divide kare, so we are able to get 7. Aur total number of stacks jo ki hame pucha gaya hai, these will be then 14. तो इस तरह से हम कोई भी क्वेश्चन, स्टेटमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर सकते हैं बाय कैलकुलेटिंग द एफसीएफ. और आने वाली सेशंस में हम सीखेंगे कि बाय कैलकुलेटिंग एलसीएम हम किस तरह के क्वेश्चंस सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. अभी थोड़ा सा एक डिफरेंट टाइप के क्वेश्चंस हम स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं. यहाँ पर हम यूक्लिड डिविजन लेमा का यूज करेंगे, बट वी डू नॉट हैव टू फाइंड एफसीएफ, देयर इज समथिंग एल्स. व्हाट दिस इज, वी हैव टू शो that every positive odd integer that can be written in the form of 4q or 4q plus 3, where q is some integer. तो इस क्वेश्चन को स्टार्ट करने से पहले एक हम थोड़ा सा जो जनरल नॉलेज हमें पहले होनी चाहिए, लेट अस डिस्कस दिस. व्हाट इट इज, इफ आई एम राइटिंग एनी नंबर, लेट इट बी 22, सो कैन बी राइट इट एज 2 into 11? Of course, yes. If there is a number 48, we can write it as 2 into 24. If there is a number 56, we can write it as 2 into 28. So we can observe from here that every number which is even can be written as 2 multiplied by something. That means we can say that every even number can be written in the form of 2 into m, where m is representing any integer. And if we are talking about the odd numbers, agar hum baat karte hain odd number ki, ek example hum aur dete hain yahan par. If I am writing any odd number, let it be 11. So can we write 11 as 2 multiplied by something? Of course, no. But we can write 11 as 2 into 5 plus 1. So 1 will be remaining. It is 10 plus 1. Similarly, if I am taking any other odd number, it is 2 into 11 plus 1. Or we can say 22 plus 1. So hum kisi bhi odd number ko kis form mein likh sakte hain? It can be written in the form of 2m plus 1. So this must be there in our general knowledge कि किसी भी even number को लिखना possible है 2 multiplied by some integer की form में, और किसी भी odd number को हम लिख सकते हैं 2 multiplied by m plus 1. तो अब हम चलते हैं अपने question की तरफ. In this question हमें यही check करना है, क्या हम किसी even number को या किसी odd number को 4q plus 1 और 4q plus 3 की फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं या फिर नहीं लिख सकते. So let us see how to start such type of question. Yes, हम सबसे पहले स्टार्ट करेंगे बाय यूजिंग आर यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा इटसेल्फ एंड वी विल से लेट अस कंसीडर ए टू बी एनी पॉजिटिव इंटीजर एंड व्हाट विल बी 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 विल बी टेकन एज 4. हमें ऑब्जर्व करना है यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा को अपने माइंड में रखना है. वी नो दैट ए इक्वल्स टू बी क्यू प्लस आर एज फार एज यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा इज कंसर्न. सो A is any general number and the number which is multiplied by Q, it is known as B. तो हम अपने question में देखते हैं यहाँ पर Q के साथ जो number multiply हो रहा है, it is 4. So we will say that B is equal to 4. So if A is any positive integer and B is equal to 4, then we can say by Euclid's division lemma, in short, I am writing it as EDL. There exists, dear viewers, observe this symbol carefully. If we have to write complete there exist, so in place of writing there exists completely, we can just write in its place this symbol. Two positive unique integers Q and R such that or for which we can say A is equal to B Q plus R or वो B की वैल्यू यहां पर है 4. So it will be 4 Q plus R. अब एक और बात की तरफ हम ध्यान देंगे और वो बात है about the remainder. हमने अभी डिस्कस किया कि the remainder will never be greater than or equal to B or will never be less than 0. यानी जो भी remainder होता है वो कभी भी negative नहीं होता. तो यहाँ पर इस question के लिए remainder क्या हो सकता है? It can be 0, it can be 1, it can be 2 or it can be 3. But the remainder cannot be 4. The reason being the value of B is 4. Remainder कभी भी B के equal नहीं होगा. It will be less than that. तो इतना concept हमें एक बार समझना है और इतना लिखने के बाद अभी अगर हम डिस्कस करते हैं फर्दर. नाउ वी विल पुट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सप्रेशन द वैल्यूज ऑफ रिमाइंडर्स वन बाय वन. हम देख सकते हैं कि इस क्वेश्चन के लिए देर आर 4 वैल्यूज फॉर द रिमाइंडर्स. इट कैन बी 0 और 1 और 2 और 3. नाउ वी आर टेकिंग दीज ऑल वैल्यूज वन बाय वन. इफ रिमाइंडर इज 0 देन व्हाट विल बी ए? इट विल बी 4 इंटू क्यू because the remainder is becoming 0, so 4q plus 0 which is equals to 4q. अब हम check करते हैं कि 4q is even or it is odd. And for checking that we will take 2 common from it. और अगर हमने 2 को common ले लिया है तो हमारे पास अंदर बचता है 2q. तो हमने अभी बात की थी कि कोई भी ऐसा number जिसे 2 multiplied by some integer की form में लिख सके, जिसे हमने यहाँ पर भी लिखा 2 multiplied by something, so that becomes an even number. 4q odd नहीं है, ये कैसा number है? Even number है. अभी हम next step करते हैं. Now we will put remainder to be 1. और अगर हमने अपने remainder को 1 put किया तो जरा देखें कि a की value क्या होगी. It will be 4q plus 1. क्या अभी भी हम 4q plus 1 में से 2 को common ले सकते हैं? So 1 is there. 2 cannot be taken common. अगर हम try भी करते हैं तो only 4q में से 2 को आप common ले पाएंगे. But 1 will be kept as it is separately. So we will say that 4q plus 1 is an odd number. हम proof में proof यही करना था कि क्या 4q plus 1 एक odd number है. So yes, it is odd. Now we will put the next value for our remainder and that next value is what here? It is 2. If we are taking remainder is equal to 2, so the value of A becomes 4q plus 2 and now we can directly see, clearly see that 2 can be taken common from here and we have 2 into 2q plus 1. Complete 4q plus 2 में से अगर हमने 2 को common लिया तो हमें मिल रहा है 2 multiplied by something. तो टू कॉमन है, दैट इज वाई दिस इज एन इवन नंबर. बिल्कुल इसी तरह से ही इन आर नेक्स्ट स्टेप वी विल टेक आर नेक्स्ट वैल्यू एंड व्हाट दैट वैल्यू इज. नाउ वी विल पुट रिमाइंडर इज इक्वल टू 3. इफ रिमाइंडर इज 3 देन द वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज 4q+3. अगर अब हम देखें कि क्या हम कॉमन ले सकते हैं 2 को, तो 3 कैन बी सेपरेटेड, इट कैन बी स्प्लिटेड इनटू 2 पार्ट्स एंड दीज 2 पार्ट्स आर 2 एंड 1. अभी टोटल 3 टर्म्स में से पहली दोनों टर्म्स में से 2 कैन बी टेकन कॉमन एंड वी हैव दस 2 इनटू 2q+1+1. फाइनली 1 हैज बीन रिटन सेपरेटली एज दिस, सो दिस नंबर विल बी एन ओड नंबर. So in the last we can say therefore every positive odd integer, chahe koi bhi odd integer ho, us odd integer ko hum likh sakte hain whether in the form of 4q+1 or in the form of 4q+3. Is there any query from our viewers? I hope no. So let us now start our next question. And the question is, show that every positive odd integer, this is of the form 6q+1, 6q+3 or 6q+5. So this is very much similar question, similar to the previous one. इसे हम एक बार quick देख लेते हैं. Since the number multiplied here with q, it is 6. That's why we will say that b is equal to 6. In this question, we will consider b to be 6. And now we have a equals to 6q plus r. And what can be the positive values for r by Euclid's division lemma? These can be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. Not greater than 6. अभी जैसे हमने previous question में किया, बिल्कुल वैसा ही हम 1 by 1. Once we will put remainder equals to 0, thus we have a equals to 6q, and of course 2 can be taken common from 6q, and thus this number will be an even number. Aise hi, if we are taking remainder to be 1, in that case the value of a, it becomes 6q+1, and this can be written as 2 into 3q, but from 1 we cannot take 2 to be common, and thus we have 2 into 3q+1 separately. That's why this is odd number. Similarly, we will put r to be 2. The value of a is 6q+2. We can clearly say that it is equal to 2 can be taken common, and thus it is 2 into 3q+1, and thus this number is an even number. So the remaining 3 value of r will also be used. Once we will put r is equal to 3, then we will put r is equal to 4, and then we will put r is equal to 5. And we will be able to see that all the odd numbers can be written in the form 6q.
Like you saw, our expert, she was trying to solve this question, and there are many such questions which she will be solving, and she has solved. So real numbers, it's not that complicated a matter, and you can too solve those questions. Let's continue solving that question, ma'am.
तन्वी जी, अभी हमने जो क्वेश्चंस डिस्कस किए इसके बाद नेक्स्ट जो क्वेश्चन है, एक्चुअली लेवल थोड़ा सा अप होता जा रहा है क्वेश्चंस का
जी.
तो इन दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू अगेन यूज यूक्लिड्स डिवीजन लेमा, बट दिस टाइम वी डू नॉट हैव टू चेक के कोई भी पॉजिटिव ओड इंटीजर जो है उसे हम 3q+1 और 4q+1 या 4q+3 की फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं या नहीं. हमें चेक करना है इस बार द स्क्वायर ऑफ एनी पॉजिटिव इंटीजर. यानी किसी भी पॉजिटिव इंटीजर का अगर हम स्क्वायर कर दें तो उस स्क्वायर को हम 3m या तो 3m plus 1 की फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं. सो बिफोर सॉल्विंग इट और बिफोर ड्राइविंग इट, लेट अस डिस्कस फॉर बाय टेकिंग सम ऑफ द एग्जांपल्स. इफ आई एम राइटिंग 4, सो वी नो दैट 4 इज द स्क्वायर ऑफ अ पॉजिटिव इंटीजर, 4 इज द स्क्वायर ऑफ 2. तो क्या हम 4 को 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय m या 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय m प्लस 1 की फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं? तो वी कैन से कैन प्लस 1, दैट मींस इट कैन बी रिटन एज 3 इनटू 1 प्लस 1, दैट मींस 3m प्लस 1 की फॉर्म में हम इसे लिख सकते हैं. बिल्कुल इसी तरह से अगर हम कोई भी नंबर, लेट मी से देयर इज अ नंबर 9 एंड आई एम टेकिंग 9 स्क्वायर, सो 9 स्क्वायर इज व्हाट, इट इज 81. क्या हम 9 के स्क्वायर को या तो 3m या तो 3m प्लस 1 की फॉर्म में लिख सकते हैं? सो यस, 81 इज अ मल्टीपल ऑफ 3, दैट्स व्हाई हम इसे 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 27 की फॉर्म में लिख पा रहे हैं. तो कोई भी नंबर को अगर हम उसका स्क्वायर करते हैं तो उस स्क्वायर को या तो 3m या तो 3m प्लस 1 की फॉर्म में लिखा जा सकता है, एंड दिस इज अ यूनिवर्सल फैक्ट. ऐसा नहीं है कि कुछ नंबर्स के स्क्वायर्स के लिए तो ये बात ट्रू होगी और बाकी कुछ दूसरे नंबर्स के स्क्वायर्स के लिए ये बात ट्रू नहीं होंगे. इट इज अ यूनिवर्सल फैक्ट. तो अभी हम देखते हैं कि जनरल नंबर्स के लिए हम इसे कैसे सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. यस, so what we will take this time, again we will consider our Euclid division lemma. We will consider this thing in our mind, a equals to bq plus r, and then we will take a to be any positive integer, and we will take b is equal to 3. Here we are using an integer m because we are not talking about the integer itself, we are talking about the square of the integer. So we dekhte hain question mein. By EDL हमें expose करने होंगे two unique integers, and these two unique positive integers will be of course q and r. And now we can say that a equals to 3q plus r. And what can be the possible values of r here? The possible values of our remainder, these can be either 0 और 1 और 2, क्योंकि हमारा डिवाइस ऑफ 1, सो 1 बाय 1 लेट अस पुट दीस वैल्यूज. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर टेकिंग आवर रिमाइंडर टू बी 0, दस व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ ए, इट इज 3q. नाउ वी विल नॉट स्टॉप दिस स्टेप हियर, क्योंकि हमें डिस्कशन करनी है अबाउट द स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस, दैट्स व्हाई वी नीड टू फाइंड द स्क्वायर. And we will go for squaring on both sides. We are able to get that a square equals to 9q square. Simply, we can say that 3 can be taken common over here. And we have 3q square remaining in the bracket. I am considering this 3q square to be some integer m. And we have taken where m equals to 3q square. जो कंप्लीट वैल्यू है 3q स्क्वायर, इसने हम इसे हमने ले लिया किसी इंटीजर m के इक्वल, और वी कैन से m1 के इक्वल. सो हम देख सकते हैं कि अगर रिमाइंडर 0 हो जाता है 3 से डिवाइड करने पर, देन वी कैन राइट इट्स स्क्वायर एज 3m. नाउ वी विल पुट द रिमाइंडर टू बी 1, एंड इफ द रिमाइंडर इज 1, देन value of a is 3q plus 1, so we have a square equals to 3q plus 1 whole square, which is of course equals to 9q square plus 1 plus 6q. Further, we can see that 9q square and 6q, in dono quantities se hum common le sakte hain 3 ko, and in the bracket we have 3q square plus 2q, and 1 is remaining outside. So if we consider this complete value to be m, we can clearly see that the square of a in this case can be written in the form of 3m plus 1. So bilkul isi tarah se we can also put are remainder to be 2, and that will be the third step for this question. And this is all for today. We will continue the same concept in our next session.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you so much for solving these questions, and like you said that we will continue the same session in the next class. So our students and viewers, they'll be more than eager to look forward to your next session. Thank you so much once again for your time and for everything.
Thank you, Tanviji. Thanks. Yeah, thank you so much. And let me come to know about the problems given by our viewers.
Absolutely. Thank you to all the viewers, to all the students for watching this session. I'm sure you liked it. And moving further, we have a science class for all the class 9 students, and we'll be talking about cell division. This would be the second part of this topic. And stay happy, stay healthy, and stay safe. We're coming back in a short while. Namaste.